The structure of DNA. So the structure of DNA is given by the scientists Watson and Crick. So that is in the model of double helix model. Double helix model. So here already I told DNA is nothing but a polymer of deoxynucleotides. So many nucleotides are formed as a, it means polymerized as a DNA. So that is in the form of double helix model. How it is formed means you are seeing here two strands are here. So two strands are anti-parallel strands. Anti-parallel strands, they are right-handed twisted strands. While they are twisting, here the grooves are formed. One is major groove and another one is minor groove, totally called as helix. So the helical structure is found here. So the length of the one helix is equal to 3.4 angstroms or 34 nanometers. In each helix approximately 10 base pairs are present. When you come to the length of the DNA, how you can you say means we are say in the form of base pairs. For example, you take the E. coli of bacterium. In the E. coli of bacterium, the length of the DNA we are saying in the form of 2.4 into 10 to the power of 6 base pairs. Otherwise also we said in the form of deoxynucleotides, number of nucleotides, also we said as number of nucleotide pairs. Sometimes we say as kilo base pairs are nothing but of one base pair, and also kilo base pairs means nothing but of 1000 base pairs. So we are saying the length of the DNA, we say the length of the DNA of particular organism in the form of base pairs only, either BP or KBP. So you take in here E. coli, whereas you come to the human being, the haploid genome, haploid content of the human DNA composed of how much of DNA do you know? 3.2 into 10 to the power of 9 base pairs. So here you are seeing here part of the DNA only. This is the model of the DNA only. In the model it is like a helix forms. So each helical structure is the length of the 3.4 angstroms. It composed of approximately 10 base pairs. So when the length of the helix and rotation, it means orientation and also number of base pairs are changing, means the types of the DNA is also changed. It means basically in the molecular biology already we studied the A type of the DNA, B type of the DNA, and Z type of the DNA. So here right-handed DNAs and left-handed DNAs, zigzag DNAs also present, and the number of base pairs also variated. According to that, they are classified into different types: ADNA, BDNA, and ZDNA. But we are seeing here model DNA that is belongs to the BDNA, that is right-handed BDNA, right-handed DNA. So that is proposed by the Watson and Crick. Okay, so it is the double helix model. So you are seeing here the length is given and how many base pairs are present, how the major grooves are produced and minor grooves are produced, and how we say the DNA. So this is about the DNA structure. But here is a question. Here is a question means we are saying in the form of base pairs only. But when you come to the measurements in the meters or kilometers, how you can get? How you can get means here I am giving the one question. So if you take the E. coli bacterium, so the length of the DNA is given according to the author. So the question is the E. coli DNA is 2.2 millimeters. How many base pairs are present? in the E. coli bacterium, given DNA. This is the question. So, he given the length of the DNA in the measurements of millimeters. But he is asking the number of base pairs. How you can you determine, how you can get the answer means here, the length of the DNA, is equivalent to total number of base pairs, into the distance between two successive base pairs. So you see here, already we know the length of the DNA in the given question. So what is that? 2.2 millimeters. Okay, 2.2 millimeters. What is the question here? Total number of how many base pairs are present? This is the question. And already we know the distance between the two successive base pair if the DNA is B type of DNA. So how much that? 0.34 nanometers. Then, so according to this we come. So you see here, 1 meter equal to 10 to the power of 9 nanometers. And 1 nanometer equal to 10 to the power of minus 9 meters. Okay, like 1 meter equal to 10 to the power of 3 millimeters. 1 millimeter equal to 10 to the power of minus 3 meters, right? And 1 nanometer equal to how much? Already I given 1 meter equal to how much? How many nanometers? 10 to the power of 9. 1 nanometer equal to 10 to the power of minus 9 meters. Here, in the question, the length is given in the measurement as millimeter. So, you take as 1 nanometer equal to 10 to the power of minus 6 millimeters, right? And now you write here. So, the nanometer should convert into the millimeters. That's why you add here 0.34 into 10 to the power of minus 6 millimeters. Okay, then you get the answer. So, 2.2 millimeters by 0.34 into 10 to the power of minus 6 millimeters, that equal to total number of base pairs present in the given DNA. So, like we solve the problem. Okay. So, here, if he given in the form of base pairs, we go as a meters or millimeters according to this principle. And if he given the total length of the DNA, we also get the total number of base pair according to this procedure.